December 19th, 1977, at the height of the Cold War, two Tupolev Tu-95, better known by their NATO codenames as Bear D, take off from an airbase near Havana, Cuba. Hours later, aboard the aircraft carrier the USS Saratoga CV-60, two F-4 Phantoms, a VF-31, are catapulted into the sky to intercept them. Lieutenant Junior Grade Edmund D. Windmill Holland.
Standing alert was boring and sometimes cold and uncomfortable, but the possibility to launch and intercept an enemy aircraft that in wartime was capable of sinking our ship was exciting.
These meetings in the sky that occurred literally thousands of times during the Cold War were symbols of the heightened tensions between the United States and the former Soviet Union. These bears would fly reconnaissance missions from Moscow and later Havana, Cuba, flying down the Central Atlantic Ocean and along the Eastern Seaboard, taking photographs of all the major vessels of the U.S. Navy, and most importantly, of its capital ships, the aircraft carriers. Soviet Navy navigator Pavel Bermestrov of the 392nd Regiment.
The Cold War over the ocean was in full swing, and we often had to meet with U.S. and NATO fighters, which not always behaved amicably and peacefully. Trust me.
Once in the sky, both sides would start taking photos of each other to get a better understanding of each other's military advances, often with comedic results. Journalistic media then frenzied the publishing of these strange photographs, and the Bear D quickly became a symbol of the tensions reigning between the two countries during the Cold War. During these photo opportunities, pilots would wave at each other, flash the peace sign or their butts, display Playboy magazines to the other side, compare cameras, show off, fly too close, and block each other's photographs with their planes. Their job was not to shoot each other down. It was to kill each other with film.
We knew that American pilots in air usually did not behave toward us too friendly. And now, such extravagance.
Lieutenant Dean Rattler Steele of VF-31.
I do remember my backseater, Lieutenant J.G.E. Holland, carrying a Playboy centerfold and pointing towards Cuba when showing it. It was also interesting to see the faces of the crew and have some interaction. That was the reason for the Playboy centerfold. I never considered the Playboy centerfold extravagant, but maybe his feelings could have been better translated as in poor taste, which I guess was true.
One thing that nobody realized at the time was that these pilots had no animosity toward each other. They were all pilots with a job to do, and do it well they did.
And where have you been, my darling young one? I've stumbled on the side of 12 misty mountains. I've walked and I crawled on 6 crooked highways.
This film will strip away the misunderstanding and layers of ignorance that has accumulated over the years since the Cold War and reveal common human values that all people share. Project Bear and Eagle. For the first time in history, U.S. and former Soviet veteran pilots reunite more than 30 years after their first encounter in the air at the height of the Cold War.